Welcome back and thanks for staying with Newsnight. Now, President Cyril Ramaphosa has appointed a commission of inquiry into alleged impropriety at the Public Investment Corporation. The commission will be headed by former Supreme Court of Appeal Judge Lex Mpati. He will be assisted by former Reserve Bank Governor Gill Marcus, as well by asset manager Emmanuel Lediga. Fedusa General Secretary Dennis George joins me now in studio to discuss this. Your reaction, Dennis, to the president's decision?
Look, Fedusa have been campaigning for a long time that we must depoliticize the PIC. And what we currently have is that the legislation allow the Deputy Minister of Finance to sit on the board as the chairperson. And we believe that this opens up the door for people that's looking for political favors and political handbacks. And we have campaigned the Portfolio Committee of Finance, and they have agreed with us that the workers must have at least 3 seats on the board of the PIC, because we want to monitor good governance, we want to monitor the implementation of black economic empowerment, because we believe that the PIC must help black businesses that have been overlooked. And we have also started to see, you know, when people are not successful to get a loan or the PIC to do business with them, the next step would be to go to the media and to make all kinds of allegations. But we believe it is important for this commission that they must look, because the principle stands that he who allege must prove. Because many people have made allegations and all these kinds of things. And I must say from my side, you know, we were very pleased with the work of the board and the CEO of the PIC, because they've grown the asset from 15 years ago when Dr. Dan Majila came onto the board. You know, the assets were standing on 500 billion. Today, the assets is at 2.something trillion. And we believe going forward, the board must keep that course. But also from our side, we think it is critical that we must also help more black people, and not only just black people, but small black people in townships to benefit, because we need to invest in the townships also.
Now, do you believe that going the route of a commission of inquiry will achieve all the things that you are hoping for, both in ensuring that it cleans up the PIC, it addresses the issues of representativity and so on that you've raised, but also you don't throw the baby out with the bathwater? In other words, you retain the good things that have been done, even if the people who may be implicated in wrongdoing now are the ones who actually...
Yeah, you must remember the allegations is been leveled against Dr. Dan Majila, because he's the CEO. But the CEO is appointed by the board, and it's the board that makes decisions. So the CEO carries out the mandate of the board. So this is not the first time that happened. The board made its own investigation against the CEO of the PIC. Also, they referred it to an external legal person to do a forensic authority. We've received the report today.
Do you believe
that report makes it clear that there's no wrongdoing?
Do you believe that Dan Majila may be wrongly or unfairly accused?
Of course. You can imagine what power the media has. You saw what happened with the rogue unit in SARS. You see the campaigns that they're running towards the people in Durban, that people were wrongfully accused. And this media is very dangerous. They can destroy people's lives. They can throw mud as much as they want to. They're not even accountable to you or to anybody else. So what we believe, that those that allege will now get the opportunity to prove, because that inquiry will have to listen. And remember, inquiry is not about a matter of guilt, but it's a matter of how do you don't repeat the same mistakes over and over. And we look forward to see the commission starting with their work, and also to see how the recommendations will come from that investigation.
Okay, that's where we're going to leave it. Dennis Joss, thanks very much for coming through at such short notice.